I've tried coming back to YouTube so many times, and every time it just feels so awkward. Like, I forget who I'm talking to, what I'm doing here, why people even watch me. So I guess instead of saying I'm back, I'll say hello, I'm Garrison, and I just got my own apartment. Well, it's not actually my own. I do have a roommate. So you're probably wondering quite a few things now, like, why would you get a one bedroom studio apartment? Why have you been missing for so long? Where are the videos at? Where are the edits? And I don't really have much of an answer. I've been trying to come up with one for a couple of years now, and I guess it's just I've moved on to different points in my life. You know, moving into an apartment, even though it's not very big, I am living in the third biggest city in the country. We are paying for this fully by ourselves. Well, with the help of our sponsor. Thank you, Unemployable, for making this happen. But I've had to kind of grow up, you know? I've spent my entire life, like literally since I was like 11 or 12, making videos for the internet. And I had to figure out how to fit in with real life and actually make a full life living, like actually pay for my own life. And I can't begin to thank everyone in my life, my family, my friends, myself, for pushing me to do this. Really no one except for me and Devin decided to do this. I found out like 2 days before we went and saw the apartment that he needed to move out, and I've been wanting to do something different with my life, so 5 days later, here we are. In our own apartment. And yeah, I know, it's not finished yet. We've only been here for like 4 days, so we're still getting situated, but I'll give you guys an official, unofficial house tour. We're gonna make a whole MTV Cribs video later, but for right now, let's just check it out. So I got my little drone over here. We're gonna use this later. We got a Ronin back there. Got some lights, a Kendama, a Juice WRLD skateboard, tapestries, of course. We have our sponsor, Unemployable, hanging. We got the kitchen, bro. And honestly, I think the coolest part, the bathroom. Also, yes, I'm vlogging with a ring light. And then we got the artillery closet. We got all our gear lined up. Guys, it's not finished yet, but I needed to make a video. All right, before we finish the story, I've got something I need to take care of. Okay, how sweet is that? Free coffee machine. Hot. It's so weird having to wear a mask just to walk out my door. Still getting used to that, but like I was saying, so yeah, I still enjoy making videos a lot. Like, it's still one of my favorite things to do, but it's just kind of become more of a job for me now. You know, I used to make videos on YouTube for fun for years, and even on YouTube, it just sort of became tiring. Like, people were expecting me to post, and like, I always had to think of something. And there wasn't always something going on in my life. There wasn't always anything interesting for me to share. So having to keep up with that kind of just made me feel burnt out. And I'm sure you guys could tell, and I know this happens to a lot of people on the internet, but I just didn't know what else to share with you guys. So that brings me to my next point. Where am I going with this? What's next? And I'm still figuring that out. I still really do enjoy making videos, but the type of videos that I like making now seem to be bigger than what I can do by myself. I've kind of reached the limits of what I can create on my own, and I'm looking to build bigger. I'm looking to build a team or be a part of a team or to join a bigger cause than just myself. And I think a lot of creators are in the same boat, and so that's why I moved to this city. So yeah, I'm not promising I'm gonna be on YouTube very often. I've got a lot of things I have to work on with my job. This isn't really what I do full time or at all anymore. Now I solely make videos for other people. I have a real estate business where I do luxury condos and listings and do photos, videos, drone work. The works, you know. So I've kind of moved away from making videos about my own life,
And I kind of wanted it that way for a while. I didn't always want to have to be on camera. I always was on camera since I was like 11 years old. And it makes you forget who you really are. It makes you feel like you're living a life of a character or someone that you're not. And it's really hard to figure out who you want to be when everyone else has their opinions on who you should be. So I think that was a necessary change in my life to really step away for at least a while and not really post everything that I was doing. You know, social media can suck you in and it can make you feel like everything you do has to be online and for other people to see. But sooner or later you realize you're not actually living it yourself then. And for me, I've been always a big proponent, and even though I'm a photographer, videographer, trying to live in the moment. And it's weird because so much of the internet today is the opposite. It's living in this weird little cube, this forbidden fruit with the bite taken right out of it. Like, I almost never use my phone when I'm actually out shooting. It's only for business and like to get a hold of me. But so many of my friends even get sucked right into the social media and people's opinions and how they need to look and all this little things that just really don't matter in real life. And it's taken me a while to figure out how to kind of do both, you know, how to live in the moment while still being able to remember it later. And for me, that's always been artwork. I don't always like to post snap stories or take pictures of just on my phone of what's going on. If I'm going to capture the moment at all, I'm gonna capture it the most beautifully I can. And it doesn't mean I'm gonna put it anywhere, but it's artwork for me. It's to look back on. It's a memoir or a catalog of all the things I've done. And instead of living through a screen, you know, it's a companion. And I think a lot of people think that's what their phone is, but from the outside, it's so easy to see how controlled people are. Like, their phones are their lives. If you've ever known a kid, like at least someone under my age, who's lost their phone or broke their phone, they forget who they are. Like, they forget how to get to school, they forget how to get home, who their best friends are. They forget all of it because all of that stuff is stored on a device. It's no longer in your brain. So as much as I can, I just say fuck it. You know, I try not to be on that. And I hope that can be inspiration to all of you guys. Instead of trying to post as much as you can, maybe the cool thing is to post less. I don't know. That's just my take. That's a little bit of where I've been and what's to come. But like I said, the future is always a mystery and all you can do is make the best of it. So that's what I'm doing right now. I'm just taking it all in. It's my new life.
Jump up in his foreign. Use to sleep on couches, now the boy is really torn. If they sleep on me, I tell them haters, go and sleep it away. Yeah, like a earthquake. Yeah, I'm dealing with another little heartbreak. Man, I wish I never met you in the first place. In that car, I'm gonna get you in the worst way. Yeah.
By far, the best part about living in the city is that even though this is frozen right now, I am 4 blocks away from the beach. Damn. How is this dude really out here in fucking boxers? I like it. That's the spirit though.
Telling me I'll die soon. I don't really want that to impact you. But I don't know, maybe I'm just paranoid. I just want the best for you. I just want what's left of you. Oh, you tell me that you're sad inside. I'm sad that I can't satisfy. Yeah, I pray that I get it right this time. Maybe we'll be alright.
Nah, it's probably better if it's just that one.
Kept that shit a secret. Now I'm letting it out the cage. Gotta let it breathe. Yeah. Ain't the same as I was a day ago. It's a miracle. It's a miracle. Take the drugs. It feels like a miracle. Take the drugs and get a little spare. I show you. Yeah. In my power to see you just smile. I want you to prosper and come proper. Even if that means I ain't by your side.
Like a earthquake. Yeah, I'm dealing with another little heartbreak. Man, I wish I never met you in the first place. In that car, I'm gonna get you in the worst way. Yeah, fell in love, but it ain't no trust. If it ain't no trust.
trust, then that girl can't be my love.